Yeah, so here doing a Muslim reception. I'm just going to show you how I personally shoot them. So most of the day we're going to be on this Miller tripod and Zion crane. Zion crane's mostly going to be the wide, the cinematic stuff, whereas the tripod, and when it's on the monopod, that's more close-ups and all that sort of detail stuff. Okay, let's do it. On the Miller tripod, got the Kingjoy quick release plate, which is about a tenner off Amazon. And this allows me to use the plates with it and keep all my Manfrotto plates. As all everything I own is Manfrotto, tend to keep everything the same because it's just so much easier. I'm gonna just set this up here. And then we've got the another Sony A7S with an autofocus 10 to 18 mil lens, 4.0 on the Zion crane. Now, what I've done with this, which is pretty cool, it's got the feet, so I can just put it down like that. And it's also got the another Kingjoy plate on, so I can go like that and then put it straight onto a tripod. Cut the camera, change it to manual focus, and then have that as my wide safety. So that's pretty handy doing that. So the first thing I like to do is set up my lights. After setting up my cameras, I like to set up my lights. Go to the DJ, make sure he's okay, give me a live feed. And then I like to get my establishing shot straight away. And I'll do that by going on the Zion crane to get that. So yeah, let's go. Okay, so we've got the establishing shot, which is the creative one, where we've got a bit of foreground to show the camera moving, that the camera is actually moving. And now I like to give myself all the editor safety shots. So what I'll do is, I'll start up at the sky, slowly come down to the building, and then wait there for about 6 seconds. Now, okay, that's lovely. That's nice. I'll do one more for better exposure. So the reason I do that is because I like to give the editor choices. If you give them a shot that's too shaky to use or something like that, then it's just, you know, that's the first shot the couple's going to see in their film, which isn't very nice. So just giving them that safe shot. So using these Yongnu lights, I got two of these. And we're putting these on Manfrotto 100 four back tripods, light stands even. Got three of these. I think these cost about 250, and they can all slide together like that, so you can just hold it like that. It's pretty decent. I used to bring light stands to shoots for the smaller ones because I was worried that people would trip over them and all that sort of stuff. But with these ones, I just put them in the corner. And they're pretty decent, they're pretty sturdy. Obviously I still keep an eye on them, but they're pretty good. And these lights, the Yongnu lights, they're about 30, 40 quid each, not including the batteries. So we're putting the light up as high as possible and out of the way of these lights so we don't get any shadows. The reason we put it up as high as possible is because otherwise you get nasty shadows of the actual sofas or the chairs and casting shadows behind, so it's just better to have them behind. And as you can see, that's pretty, if someone goes like that, then you're not going to get sued too much, so yeah. Okay, and we're shooting 50 frames per second, it's obviously 100 shutter speed. And now I don't like that fire extinguisher over there, so won't be shooting that way. So what I'll be doing is, I'll be having this background more, if anything, and I need to also watch out for those lights up there, because that's casting a shadow on me. Just need to also make sure there isn't anything wrong with it as well, like no bits or whatever. And like, I can see something here sticking out, so I'm just gonna see if I can tuck that in. Yep, there we go. Yeah, lovely. Okay, yeah, so let's make it all symmetrical, and I'll go for the shot. I've just turned the design crane upside down so I can get a lower angle, and that's more of a cinematic shot, and it's more of a empowering shot for the shot. Okay, and here we go. Make sure you do those steady cam knees. And now I am getting a bit of my own shadow in, so I'm going to do that again, but closer. Lovely. And while I'm here, while I've got it, I'm just going to get a few close-ups with it. So we've got the cake over there, but as you can see, there's no glasses, there's no knives or anything like that. It's also not in the best location in terms of background. Probably what the best thing to do is to get a quick safety shot of it now. So we have it in the bag, but actually get the actual shots when they put it on the dance floor, if they put it on the dance floor, which is also something that I do need to check and ask the planner. So let's get a few wides of the actual venue, of the actual tables, and then we'll go on the 7200 and get all the close-up details of that. Cool. When I get table shots, usually I'm looking for any natural light, because natural light would be the softest and the nicest. However, there isn't any natural light coming in here. So I want to make it look as busy and expensive as possible, which is your goal as a videographer, obviously. So I'm obviously going to start at the back and try to find the nicest looking background. So looking around, I would say it's over there or over there, facing either that table or the chairs. So making a decision, I would say I would get a quick shot here actually, yeah. Give myself some variety, yeah. Especially if something only takes like a few seconds to do, it's always worth doing. So I'm just gonna turn my f-stop up, make sure my lens is clean, yep. And cause I'm 6'2", I can get some pretty cool shots doing this sort of stuff. And then we'll get some other shots like this, making sure the knees are still bent. And then we'll go into a close-up of the table and then do a 360. And then pan up now that I know I need that shot. Keeping those knees bent. Yep, okay, and then I've got that, so I'll probably just get a quick safety here. Looking at the nicest location, which is that way. Always need to be conscious of the background. I don't like that shot, so I'll just come down. No. I don't like that shot, but I've never done it before. If you're not trying new stuff, then what's the point? So one of the reasons I go left to right, especially for establishing shots, is because we read and write left to right. And there's something psychological about that. So like we're used to seeing it, you know, that way. So whenever I see someone go right to left, unless there's a particular reason where like they have to come from that way, then I'm kind of like, I don't really like that shot. And I really don't like establishing shots in other people's films where it goes right to left. But that's just preference, and you know, they've been doing it a lot longer than I have, and you know, as long as the client's happy and as long as they're happy, everyone can do what they want. So now, I want to triple check that this is one of the only rooms that we're going to be filming in, because otherwise, you know, I've done it before when I first started out where I filmed a massive room and then I set all my lights up and stuff, and then I realized there was an even bigger room right next door to it. So it's one of those things where you just learn from your experiences. It's not all about the filming, it's not all about the lighting, it's more about asking the right questions to both the planners and the DJs and the photographers, and yeah, that's what I find anyway. Right.
But speed light uses a lot less power.
Okay.
And the reason why a speed light is about the same is because a speed light is directed light, whereas this goes everywhere.
Oh, so that's so flood and then numbers, that's spot. Yeah.
So the guide number is the same.
Yeah, and you don't have to be walking around with chairs. And he goes to me, oh, I never do what anyone else tells me to. And in my head, I'm like, what?
You're an idiot.
If someone tells me to try something, then I'm going to try it because I want to. I've been doing this 7 years, but I want to learn.
Yeah.
If you need to be open-minded, this is why I'll probably never do photography. But that stuff's interests me. I'd rather listen more than I'm talking.
Yeah.
Which doesn't always happen, but yeah. Okay. So with this one, we're using the small HD 502. For weddings, it is overkill. This tripod is overkill for weddings. I wouldn't have got it if I didn't do corporate stuff as well. So this is actually for my FS7 setup. But what I like about this is because a lot of the time I'm squinting at like a small screen and I don't have as many exposure tools and stuff like that. And when I like to put this tripod high up for the dancing, I can just go like this and I can easily see it. Whereas with this screen, it only goes down to there and it's still squinting to see if it's in focus and stuff like that. This monitor is really good for me. Also, if I need to go somewhere else for like speeches or something like that, what I've done in the past, I can see the screen a lot better when I'm far away from it to make sure no one's walked out of shot or anything like that. And also, so if I'm shooting over there with my other camera, I can just go like that and it's, you know, I can see it easy, really. Yeah. So now we'll go round. Now that we've got all our wides, all our safety shots, I can go around with this and get some creative close-ups of this. So things I want to get is like glasses, the flowers, anything that costs money, I want to capture. And my mission is to make everything look as expensive as possible, as cinematic as possible, and doing it as quickly as possible within reason, because obviously there are a lot of other stuff I need to get on with. So let's do this. We have picked this one because it's at the back of the room and we've got lots of nice color and texture in the background. And so what we'll do is, instead of exposing it with a light up here, what I'll do is I'll just turn this backlight on. And this will actually make it look a lot more cinematic. Now, as you can see as well, on this particular one, I've never actually really seen this before, but they've actually got spotlights on the table. Now, that was a theme that obviously they wanted to go for, so I don't want to blast that light and just completely, you know, be like, hey, wait a second, I had a spotlight there, so. And I want to keep it as natural as possible whilst giving myself good exposure. Okay, so let's go over here. And it would help if I had a battery in there. Whenever I get these sort of shots, I want to make it a bit more interesting by having something refract inside of in front of the lens. And whenever you change something about the table, you always need to put things back to how you found them. Otherwise, chances are some waiter or waitress who's, you know, getting in trouble with their manager. So I always just try to keep that in mind. So I want to pan down because the title is at the top. And then one more without the glass in case I don't like that, because I didn't actually like that shot with the glass. That's too quick. That glass is a little bit dirty. Now I want to get some of the balloons. And so with the 70-200, always love doing this. If you backlight them, that's always nice. If that's blue, if the background bokeh is blue, then I usually like to make the foreground lighting tungsten and give it a bit of contrast. But generally, keep it within the same theme of what it actually looks like. So I quite like that. I mean, the close-up was nice, but I'll get the close-up as well for safety.
Okay.
So with the 70-200, got nice perspective changes. That was a bit shaky. So the problem we're having is every time someone walks in this entire room, the floor shakes a bit. And obviously that just shakes the tripod, which shakes the camera. So if it's noticeable, we do have to reshoot that shot. Now what I find a bit crazy is that a lot of people always want the latest gimbal and the latest lens and the latest everything. But as I've started freelance editing a lot of the time, and I see other people's footages while they're filming, their tripods aren't that smooth. Even though they spend like £200 on it, and it's like £200, it's Manfrotto, it's, you know, good brands, their tripod stuff just isn't smooth. I always find like tripods are usually like the backbone of your kit, and I think you should invest a lot of money into a tripod. I mean, something like this is just perfect for me, but this is a little bit too much to spend on, you know, just for a piece of wedding kit. So I do think people should spend a bit more money on their tripods. So I'm getting my safety shot where it's static, and then just in case I want to give it a bit of motion, let's give it like a slight pan up when people, when it's not shaky. Especially if there's a lot of white backgrounds, obviously you get your wide on the gimbal, bit of motion. And then with the 200mm, it's great for obviously, you know, putting things out of focus, having bokeh in the background, especially if you shoot your things up, because then all these things are massive blue dots in the ceiling. You've also got little patches of light, which when it's out of focus, it's just really, really nice. So for gimbal and 200mm on a location like this, I think it's perfect. Yeah. So with mingling shots, I like to get them when they're actually busy, because I want to get, you know, I want to make it look as busy as possible, and I don't really like it when there's only one or two people and the background's quite empty. It looks like not too many people turned up as well. And yeah, it's a bit too spacious around there. And more importantly is that the people you're filming don't look very comfortable, because usually it's just they're in a room on their own and it's a random stranger with a beard's just come over and started filming them. So if people see other people getting filmed first, then it's like, oh, okay, cool, that's what he's doing. And it's much better. Otherwise, if you're just filming on your own, being filmed on your own, it's kind of like, ah, oh, it's weird. So with this sort of stuff, I don't need to take a light because it's next to a window. I want to keep it looking as natural as possible. The main reasons I use a light is either to make it really cinematic in speeches or cakes or anything like that. But stuff like this, you know, it's more candid stuff. I just want everything looking more natural as possible. Yeah. Just casually sit on the floor. Oh shit. Probably not even going to use this, to be honest. Yeah, I'm not going to use that. Don't like it. Hiya, you alright, Charlie?
Charlie, good to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Tube to MP3.
I started listening to some Indian songs on the way home from my job the other day, wedding the other day, and I was like, damn, I'm turning into an Indian.
If your car plays MP3s, you can take this one.
Yeah, so groom's actually really cool. seems appreciative and very, yeah, seems very chilled out, which will make today a lot easier. So now, while people are here, I usually don't get my wide shots until it's at the busiest time, because again, I want everything to look as busy and expensive and as fun as possible. But I do like getting my safe shots as well. So I'll just quickly go around, do a quick semicircle, get the wide. So I'll probably do a full 360 to make sure I get everyone's faces in. Because at the end of the day, couples might not necessarily feel like it's, couples might not always be like, oh yeah, we want it just to look as busy and expensive as possible. Sometimes they just want it to have their friends and family's faces in, which is completely reasonable. And it's something that I should probably do more of. Yeah. So for mingling shots and everything else, always want to obviously make sure I introduce myself to the groom and the bride and everyone like that. And also want to make sure I'm smiling at all the guests as well. Actually got a bit of feedback the other day. I was like, okay, this guy gave me a really good compliment saying, talking about my filming. And I said to him, okay, any advice? Because it was a bar mitzvah. And I've done about 10 bar mitzvahs, but you know, I always, for regular clients, I always like to ask, you know, some of the time I'm like, do you have any advice? Because I always want to learn. And he was like, yeah, just smile more. So I was like, oh, but it's my concentration face. And you know, clients might not really see it that way. They might just think I'm being rude. But yeah, I find it really difficult to smile. So when I smile at people, I don't think they know that I'm smiling. So we'll see. We'll see.
That's great for the marriage. I'd like to follow these very short ceremonies.
The nikah is currently taking place, the little ceremony. But they actually said they're not too fussed if I get it or I don't. So at the moment, I've got a camera over there recording a wide. And I'm just gonna stick another audio recorder down for the priest. And then I'm gonna use that camera there for close-up. Now, it was my understanding that the nikah had already happened because it was scheduled for about an hour or so ago. And we're actually supposed to be doing couple shoots, which was supposed to happen 20 minutes ago. So yeah, it's just a bit of time there. But I guess what I could learn from next time is ask, have you already done the nikah? And that'd be a lot safer.
God said this life is the enjoyment of deception. God is telling us, listen, I've created this world. This is the enjoyment of deception. Has no reason. Well, there's no radiation. Whatever you have, that what we put on them, not what we get. Not what we get out of them. So people also get this. They think there is a loving marriage. I'm going to ask you, yes or no? In a way, I don't think you understand the inner way. In feelings and dealings, it has to be that way. My wife is the best. My husband is the best. So I don't want to be like, right? And we learn from it. Don't spouse it. I'll garment for you. And goodness, how we forgot. Yeah, we need this. We need this reminding word. Of course.
Smiling more now, so that's good. So I believe we're going to do a couple shoots now. This is also why I love this gimbal. It's because I can easily just adapt to any situation. Okay. Oh, where's the audio recorder? There it is. So, is this cool? Yeah. So, Zoom H1 audio recorders on auto. When you don't have a road link or road mic or anything on top of the camera, I can just quickly shove it onto a table and you'll get some usable audio. So. I can only take one piece of equipment because I'm going on the golf buggy. So I'm going to opt to go for a monopod and a 50mm, just because I can get more creative with that. And with the with this gimbal, it's mostly better for wides. So I don't want to just keep giving the same bad, you know, gimbal shots, really. So yeah, I'm going to be. Which way are they going?
They're going up that way.
That way. Okay, cool. I'll. Yeah, that's fine.
Stay.
Oh, I wish I could. Are you getting a shot as well? Or?
No. Oh, yeah, you can show your own. Thank you.
Are you guys in the middle of something?
No.
Okay, could you guys just be talking to each other and having an actual conversation? Something upbeat. Oh, absolutely. That's very upbeat, and yes. So how awkward is your first dance? Yeah, are you having a first dance?
Oh, yeah, so the thing is, I don't know. And we can use
I'm not intrusive at all.
We can use one the rest of the disc to kind of, you know, because the nap might not have a couple of songs.
Who's looking after them? So if they're going
both
missing,
of our rings.
Both of our rings.
You've actually got pain on your one of your
yes, nails. I know.
Are you doing stuff?
Oh, no, I am though.
Oh, you are?
Just being a creepy guy. That's camera right. Behind you. And then just touch it gently.
Touch it like you like it.
I mean.
Stroke it like it's a puppy. There we go. Got it.
Thank you.
And then. So I've got your hands, need your. Head pendant? What do you call it?
Head pendant is fine.
Bindi.
Bindi, that's Bindi the one, isn't it?
So the next time you go to one of the weddings and
they'll
stuff,
be like, oh,
like, nice Bindi. I'm like, oh, he knows.
It's not going to be the head, it's going to mean something naughty, isn't it? It's like, namaste, abkese hair.
Oh, see?
Of course. Shukra. I'm not pronouncing it right, but like it means thank you. I read it on like an app.
Shukriya.
Yeah. It was like 2 years ago. I was like, oh, I'm gonna learn Hindi, Shukriya. And I got as far as those two.
Good start.
Yeah, but I don't know who speaks Hindi. It's like you got Gujarati
Yeah. I'm Gujarati.
I speak Hindi and Urdu and Punjabi.
So we're both a bit different.
Okay, if you just keep there, and then when I say go, I just want you to look up at the lens. And then look.
Do I just keep looking?
Yeah, keep staring. It's like, okay, okay, close your eyes. 3, 2, 1, and Beyonce. Okay, that's enough. Okay, so I always look through the eyepiece because it gives you a bigger vision. Whereas looking at this, it's not that great. Even though I am, you know, zooming in, stuff like that. I'm just getting some general B-roll, trying to get, you know, the atmosphere. So I'm looking for cool ruins like that. I'm looking for swans. I'm looking for flowers. I want to get a close-up of the water, like a reflection somewhere. And I want to sort of set the scene with whatever I can, really. Because it's obviously not just about getting the couple shots. It's also about, you know, the environment when you've got time. So, yeah. And then I'm just going to give it a little bit of wiggle to give it like a bit of atmosphere. I've got my safe non-wiggly shot. So if I don't like the wiggle, I can just not use it. Actually, I'm going to go over there, and then with this lens, I'm going to shoot through the yellow plants so I get a bit of foreground. Make it a little bit nicer. Now I'm just using my leg and two hands to keep the shot steady. Sometimes I put my shoulder into it as well, and that just makes it a lot steadier. Flower looks a little bit dead, so in the edit I don't think I will be using that, because I want everything to look as alive as possible and healthy as possible. That duck's got something on its back. I think it's just dirt. Good shot there. I know what a bindi is now. And just have a general conversation with them.
So, Charlie knows what a bindi is now, and it's not a rude word.
You sure?
It's definitely not a rude word.
You can Google it and see them.
Yeah, and then walk, when I say walk towards me, and then look as if it's the first time you've seen it, but don't overdo it. No one wants to see that. Oh my God, he's handsome. Just this place. First time you've seen this place. Yeah. I'm going to walk back, Johnny, so yeah. So become center with me. There we go, lovely. Yeah, don't look at me. Look straight over me, be like, wow. But don't overdo it. And action. About chicka, wow, wow. Yeah, and then keep it there. Very nice. Okay, lovely. Thank you, I got it. All yours, Ravi.
First shot.
I'm saying sort of silly things lately. Having a good time myself. Because I want to make this couple feel relaxed, and from the moment I spoke to the bride on the phone, she didn't want anything cheesy or overly cinematic in terms of couple shots. So in order to do that, I need them to be as natural as possible, laugh naturally. So I'd rather not say, okay, laugh now. I'd rather just say something stupid to make them laugh. And then, yeah, I think you get better natural content out of that. I think from now on, I want to get more natural stuff. Put them in cool poses, locations, stuff like that, but just get natural stuff, because I've done too much of that cinematic stuff where you're spinning and they're walking up, and yeah, I don't really think I like too much of that anymore. So I'm constantly changing what I like, my preferences and stuff like that. So yeah, it's the way that I'm still as passionate about weddings as I am now than I was when I started 7 years ago, if not more passionate. So yeah, you need to keep changing it up, I think. Yeah. And then film stuff over there. Is that any good? No, that's not good. I get some tree shots. Actually. Okay. Yeah, keep filming. So ask the DJ which cable he needs. And we've got, that's why I've got XLR, phono, and jack. And I'm just going to give him a jack. And then that will go into this Zoom H6. And then I'll just monitor it every so often. So it's all good. Is that where you want it? Yep, lovely, thank you. I don't have my headphones on me, actually.
Yeah, they're ready.
I need about 5 minutes.
You need five minutes?
Yeah, because video, yeah.
Okay, fine. Is it a video then?
No, I'm recording the video, yeah.
Oh, okay. 5 minutes, yeah. Okay, fine.
Thank you. Okay, lovely, that's done. Okay, key is just to be like super chill and like not stressed. and only focus on solutions rather than the problem, because otherwise it's gonna not be great. I couldn't do a live, I couldn't sort my audio out earlier because the main guy wasn't around, which is fair enough. And couldn't sort this out because this is for my photo shoot stuff. So had my hands tied. It's usually why you have another videographer to get these sort of to get this sort of stuff. 2%. Okay, I need to change my battery. Lovely. So what I'll do is I'll put this one over here as a wide safe. So this will get like reactions and stuff. Actually, I'm gonna stick it over there because that'd be better reactions. Yep, so that's rolling. I can then stick this over here as that one. Are you, Ravi, are you ready?
We're ready.
I'm ready as well.
Dude, I'm just gonna do this freestyle.
Sorry. This camera's rolling, by the way, for reactions. Yeah, cool. Cheers. Are you walking back with them, or are you going to stay here, or?
How do you want to do it?
Ideally, I'd walk back with them, but I'm not fussed. I'm quite easy.
Okay, we'll do that.
Walk back? Yeah. Lovely, thank you. I need to move that light stand out the way. There's no surprise speeches, announcements, is there, that you know of?
There's some dances, and I think there's a couple of speeches as well.
There is, okay. That wasn't on the itinerary. Okay. Ravi, apparently there might be speeches. And there might be a special dance. I'm not sure if you've heard of that. I've not been told. So I'm just getting a quick safety shot of this. Got my shadow in there while I've got time. Okay, a couple's coming, so I'll get it later. So we're going to be walking back. So with you, stand by next to my camera. That's in the corner, but don't stand in front of it, yeah? Please also double check with both of us that
Cool. Right now,
okay, so usually I go around with like a 50 mil and get all the table shots, or sometimes also on the gimbal. Luckily there's enough light in here, about quite far behind on schedule, so we're cutting a lot of stuff out, but now I just need to go around all the tables, make sure I got all the faces of friends and family, because that's probably one of the more important things of getting on the wedding. They want to see who turned up, they want to see, you know, people enjoying themselves and stuff like that, and I need to do it before people start eating, otherwise it's just really bad, really bad pictures, really.
Your seats here, starters are now being sorted to the tables.
Okay.
so they are going to do the photos. I'm just finding out how many is going to be, if it's just with family or not.
Okay.
But it will be in like 45 minutes. So they're going to do starters for half an hour now.
Yep.
Then they're going to do the ring exchange. And then they're going to go on to the photos with guests.
Okay. So half an hour starters, ring exchange, and then photos.
Yep.
No dancing.
I think there will be, but I don't know how long it'll be.
Okay. Okay. Nobody put anything in their mouths. Nobody sneeze. Lovely. That's it. Big smiles. This will go nicely with the Bollywood music. I've done something a little bit different today. Because it's my own gig, and I'm going to start doing it on freelance gigs. A lot of time I don't like, I never like filming people eating, because you just get really bad shots. People are just like looking at you like, and their mouth's half open. People are looking disgusted at, you know, at the camera, and it's not nice shots. So now I'm talking to each table saying, hey, just going to film you for a second. Don't put anything in your mouths and have a joke about it. And be like, okay, don't do anything disgusting. I'm filming. Oh, I'm going to put some nice Bollywood music. Stuff like that. And that way, what I've just found out, what I experimented with, is that everyone's actually not putting stuff in their mouths. Everyone's looking at the camera, smiling. Because you're having a joke with them, they're not looking at you weirdly. They're not chewing. They're not looking bad. So yeah, I think if you talk to them, it's so much better. I mean, obviously it's easy for me to say now because there's about four times less people than, you know, there are on the huge weddings where people invite everyone. But on this one, it's, you know, it's a lot less people, which is a good thing. Yeah, I'm not setting up any lights for this bit because they're quite nicely lit already. And it's quite soft lighting as well. It's not ugly lighting at all because the spot's coming straight from there. Whereas if it was coming from, if it's coming directly from the top, then, you know, you get loads of ugly shadows under the nose and stuff like that. But this is quite flattering lighting, so I don't need to put any up. I might need to put up more lights for the dance floor. I'm going to have them on standby just in case they do decide to turn the lights off. And to make sure I am actually going to get the good lighting that I want, I'm going to ask a venue person or the DJ or both if they're going to turn these lights off. I don't think they would turn off the little dots, but they might turn off those things.
Apparently, just before the ring ceremony takes place here tonight, Azeen has got a quick speech.
One sec. Come on. One sec. Cable. 1 sec. Let me. Two secs. And then you can see the ring. Yep. Can you tell I've never done that before?
You know, if she puts you on top, then it's
better. I know, but like,
the guy is
emasculating if she's on top, you know?
On top.
And then, yeah, that's fine, yeah. And then you put your hand there. Just there, on her. Yep. Yeah, that would do. Maybe it's just me, like.
No.
If a girl puts her hand on top of mine, I'm like, no, it's. Just look at that one for now. She's the professional of the day. Okay. Yep. Okay, so use this sturdier tripod. because it's a lot smoother panning and tilting. It can also go up really quite high. That one is more of a lightweight tripod. I can just pick it up and then put on the quick release plate quite easily. I had to put that light up there because the people who stand at the back, they're quite shadowy. And it just fills up the, it's a bit more of a fill light than anything. And that's why I had it on standby over there, because I can easily just bring it over there. It's the same with audio recorders. Sometimes you never know if you need them. Like there was a surprise speech, that's why I had an audio recorder in there, also as a backup. Also had a Zoom One H1 in my pocket as well, so I could quickly chuck it near the speaker should I need to. But fortunately I knew that audio was all good. So for me it's all about having backup lights, having backup Zoom H1s. Because even though I asked a few people a few times, are there going to be any speeches or anything like that? A lot of people said they don't know, or that there wasn't going to be any. There wasn't any in the itinerary, so it's just about having that sort of experience to know that not everyone knows what's going on, and so you should always prepare as if there will be, and that's that way you will never be caught on guard, off guard, I think. Yeah. Yep.
Right, legends, kindly take your seats here tonight. The bridal groom will be cutting their cake in the next couple of minutes here tonight. Kindly take your seat. 4, 3.
So at the moment, going between reactions of the couple, reactions of everyone else, because that's what helps sell it, on the close-up, and also going on the gimbal, getting some random slow motion shots on there, a few pans. So that's my wide safety over there, so swapping between manual focus and autofocus on that one. Get a few shots around here, a few wides. Just trying to keep it really interesting, really. So obviously I just need to double check the audio. It's all good, recorded two channels, it's fine. So reaction to what kind of sell this, so I want to get everyone who's laughing pretty much. If there's an unhappy face in it, then I'll try to frame them out or just not get them. Shadows and a bit too much purple, so yeah, I want to stick that on. Put it forward because I've got a bit of the armchair in. I need to be smiling the whole time purely because the wide's going to get me in shot, which is just up there. Yeah. And with this, I want to be able to have this entirely safe. I just need to make sure I'm not in the photographer's shot either. Or in his flash. So I'm constantly changing the angle of the lens. Just want to keep giving it as much variety as possible. Keep it as interesting as possible. So after this, I'll go on close-ups on 24-105. And I'm constantly looking around me so that I can make sure nothing else important is happening. So like if the dad or someone's dancing, who never dances, and I always want to make sure I'm getting those. I find that every time you leave the dance floor, for whatever reason, change a battery or something, someone always screams, and it's like, oh, what's going on? So I want a higher position, so I'm going to stick it up here. And then with this tripod, you can also just raise it up like that. And then what I'll do is I'll stick it on lock. So I can turn it down like this. Turn up the ISO. And this is now my new wide safety camera. Yep. And now it's safe to operate this. So I'll bring this down just a little bit so then I can actually operate, because at the moment I don't have my small HD because the batteries are in the behind the scenes camera. But usually I'd have the small HD looking down at me straight like that. Stick it on APS-C mode so I can get even closer. Might need to turn those lights up. Yeah, I'm gonna move those, turn those lights up. So Bride's just come onto the dance floor. That's why you need to always be looking, that's why I always seem to be looking around the dance floor. I'm sure that I've got like a massive resting, miserable face on me right now. That's because I'm looking at focusing. Double check that my safety camera's okay. Okay, now as I can see, kids have just come up onto the dance floor and started bouncing around. Now that's bouncing my camera. And that's one of the reasons you always need to make sure that you're checking the safety cameras and stuff. Now this angle isn't gonna be as nice. And as soon as I do this, the kids are gonna go off stage. Yep, so now I can put it back up. And they've come back up again, okay. Yep, so now we need to bring it back down. I could just tell the kids not to bounce there, but I kind of tripped over one earlier, so I don't think I'm in their best books. So back on the close-up, trying to get loads of shots of the bride. Make sure that's level. Almost. She's ball pin, there we go. Just trying to pick off anyone who's an obvious close family. Trying to get all the laughing, anything important happening. Turn this around a little bit. I want to go higher. I'm not getting the best shot, so I want to go higher. Level it off again, using my head to help. I'm going to lock this off as a wide so then I can move my other wide. There we go. And every time I put my camera up here, the kids come up, so then it's constantly bouncing and jolting the camera. I think what I'm going to have to do, because this one's jolting too much, because the tripod's not as heavy, I'm going to have to just go with this through the crowd now that it's busier. Make sure that light is facing everyone. And the key here is also to smile at the guests, otherwise you're just some annoying person shoving the camera in the face. Even though I hate smiling. Thank you. shot now. So I need to tilt it down like this. Make sure it's locked off, otherwise my camera is coming off. Make sure that's all fine. Bring it down like that. Oh, it's not actually busy enough for a jib shot anymore. That's a bit of a shame. But as I've got it, it's all right. Triple check. Take my jacket off, but I've that was weird timing. I'd usually take my jacket off, but I had too much food, and now my buttons are a little bit too stretched. My shirt's a bit too small for me now, so that doesn't really look good. So if it means I have to burn and be really really hot, then so be it. But yeah, no worries, man. It was all good. It was lovely to meet you. Yeah.